Again, I'm John Pace from New Life Christian Ministries in Niceville, Florida. I want to give a shout out to my Niceville Christian Ministries family in Florida. Thank you guys so much for your support. God bless you, and we're doing some phenomenal things. Listen, thank you so much for tuning into tonight's broadcast. It's going to be another phenomenal hour of interviews and inspiring word and worship that you're going to enjoy. So don't turn that channel. Stay tuned, and we'll be right back. Let's go to music.
Brought my people out of Egypt. I promised I would never leave them alone. I fed them manna in the desert. Give them my law and tablets of stone. I will make a new covenant with Israel. I will put my law in their heart. I will pour my spirit out upon them. I will be the Lord their God. And I brought my children in. They grew rich and turned away from me. So I dispersed them throughout all the nations. But I promised them eternally. That I will make a new covenant with Israel. That I will put my law in their heart. That I will pour my spirit out upon them. I will be the Lord their God. Now I have brought Jacob back to my land, back to Jerusalem, my home. They shall dwell in peace before me forever. Israel, you are no longer. For I have made a new covenant with Israel, and I have put my law in their hearts, and I am pouring my spirit out upon them, and I will be the Lord their God. Yes, I have made a new covenant with Israel. I have put my law in their hearts, and I am pouring my spirit out upon them. For I am that I am, and I will be the Lord their God.
Amen. Welcome back. Are you excited? I know at home you're pumped up and you're ready, and we've got another great hour. Listen, this hour is going to be dedicated to a unique group of people who are doing a unique thing. And I want you to stay tuned because it's going to be a time of learning for you and just insight in some areas that may challenge you in some things, but I tell you, God is in this thing, and I want you to stay tuned because it's going to be phenomenal. My next guests tonight are two young men along with his wife, and they're doing some great things with the Wilderness Mountain Ministry. I want you to welcome Jackie and Steve.
Glad to be here.
Bless you, man.
Glad to be here.
Pleasure to meet you guys. Tell us, introduce yourselves individually, and then let's just go as God is leading us tonight to share.
I'm Steve Zarling.
Okay.
I'm Jackie Grissom.
All right.
And I'm Kim Grissom, Jackie's wife.
Awesome. All right. Who wants to start?
John, wherever you want to go.
All right. Tell us about this, the wilderness piece, and let's stop. Let's talk about Israel. Talk about what you're doing and the correlation to Israel and what God said to us as it relates to us blessing Israel and how God will bless us.
Well, we know in the end time that the Lord had promised that he would preserve a place in the wilderness to keep his people in this time that we know that it's coming by the events, news events that are occurring on the face of the earth, the time of Jacob's trouble.
Gotcha.
And of course, Jackie and I had met back in 2003 at a gathering and in South Carolina. And we didn't know each other. We had no idea that the Lord had been dealing with each other on the same subject.
Wow.
He just brought us together into this magnificent humanitarian work. And we have been to Israel many times since our meeting, trying to set up, find a place in Israel that we know that the Lord wants us to set up as a distribution center during this time of trouble.
Okay. Jackie?
Yes, we're kind of like a Joseph ministry.
Okay.
And you remember history when
Absolutely.
Joseph, he knew the good years
mm-hmm.
and he knew the bad years.
Yes.
And I'm what you call an eschatologist
okay.
who deals with prophecy, and the testimony of Jesus Christ is the spirit of prophecy.
Amen.
So we have some things to share here of why we need to get this wheat into Israel, because we have a small window of opportunity to do so.
Mm-hmm.
And so I brought some scriptures along.
Okay.
I didn't want to bring the Bible. I just
Absolutely.
Jotted them down. And so if we remember, Joseph was gifted with dreams and
That's
visions.
Right. That's correct.
And, he also reconciled his brothers by this famine and drought.
Absolutely.
And we compare that to this
gotcha.
Ministry. And so Stephen, our ministry is going to be in Israel
okay.
very soon. We're in the process right now of purchasing property.
That's amazing.
And we are in the process of getting long-term visas.
Good.
And things in God is wonderful. He's opening doors.
Mm-hmm.
And so, Revelation chapter 11 predicts another 3.5-year drought
okay.
that is coming to Israel.
Okay.
And we know in history, back in the days of Elijah, there was a 3.5-year drought.
Yes.
As God was dealing with Israel. And how I got to time, I deal with time.
Okay.
And this is how I got it, John. It's back in 2011.
Okay.
God had put it on my heart where Daniel, the prophet, had left off.
Gotcha.
And he told Daniel to seal up the vision until the time of the end.
Okay.
And so God told me, I want you to go to Revelation chapter 22. I'm going to show you something where Daniel left off.
Wow.
And where John the Revelator left off. And it says, seal not the sayings of the prophecy of this book, for the time is at hand.
Wow.
And what I got out of that is God, having mercy upon us, and pouring his spirit out upon us,
mm-hmm.
and that, whosoever will,
yeah.
let him come, take the water of life freely.
That's good.
And that's such a blessing to know
mm-hmm.
that, that through any trials or whatever we're going through, tribulations,
yeah.
We can have comfort.
Yeah.
And I believe that, we Gentiles, we Christians are to stand by Israel.
Yeah.
If we're going to be blessed, God said, he swore to Abraham, I will bless those that bless thee.
That's good.
And I believe that in helping feeding the immigrants,
mm-hmm.
That's returning to Israel, making Aliyah,
yeah.
I believe that a lot of blessings are going to come to the Christians, because everywhere you look, there's something wrong with people. They're
yeah.
sick, they got tumors, they have cancers, all kinds of curses.
Yeah.
I know you'd have to agree that we are under a curse.
I do.
Now, there's two...
Hold on before you go for it. I want to talk about something that
okay.
you mentioned, because I think it's important for the viewers that are watching.
Okay.
Let's talk about time-sensitive matters.
All
let's
right.
talk about how in the Old Testament, the Bible told us about the sons of Issachar, who had understandings of the times and seasons. So I want to back up a little bit to talk about why in this time you felt it's a sensitive time, and this is the time for you guys to do this type of ministry, because it's like preparation for something that's going to happen. Mm-hmm. And so the timing is critical. So let's talk a little bit about, let's stop for a moment so that our viewers can grasp how big this is, the magnitude of this thing, because the vision was given to Joseph prior to the things happening. Mm-hmm. And it gave him foresight so that he could prepare himself. And so the ministry that you have is a ministry of logistics, if you think about it.
Yes.
And so as you're talking about a logistics ministry, talk about the timing of a matter. Why this time? Why now?
Okay. Why now is because I believe that God had showed me when Daniel's 70th week had begun that us Gentiles had a 3.5-year period to prepare.
Gotcha.
Preparation.
For the hard
task. Preparation is the key. And if that's the case, we are 2014 near the final feast would split it right down the middle.
Gotcha.
And that wouldn't give us but about a year and a maybe a half or so to ship this wheat and get it into Israel and stored.
Gotcha.
For the immigrants. And so that's very important. Thank you so much.
So if you had not responded, I want to get to something because it's important that you moved in obedience to respond to God.
Amen.
And it may not be a lot of other people didn't hear it, but you heard it.
I heard
and
it.
Your obedience is now, something is happening, and I'm talking prophetically here. So your obedience in this strategic moment, in this time-sensitive moment, your obedience to God is preparing for someone and something they don't even know that the preparation is coming.
Correct.
But God has already spoke to you to be obedient in another country.
Amen.
Yes.
In another country, to be obedient to aid another country. That's not something to run over. Because you're obedient here, and it really has nothing to do with this soil, but it has everything to do with the place that God loves, which is Israel.
Amen.
And so I want our viewers to know that, because God could be talking to them about something unique. And they're saying, well, God, nobody else hears this.
Exactly.
And if in their obedience, just like you're obeying now, your obedience today is going to bless Israel and the people of Israel in a couple of years from now.
Yes.
Okay, definitely. You can go ahead. I just wanted to share that piece because that the time-sensitive issue with this whole dynamic is very important.
Definitely. And also, you know, the time is of the essence. Mm-hmm. Because we're dealing with three issues here.
Okay.
And to feed the immigrants.
Gotcha.
Number one is war with Israel's enemies. You know, it's going to stop commerce.
Okay.
The commerce.
Gotcha.
And we're going to have also number two is the cashless system that's coming. Number three is a 3.5-year drought, you know, in Israel, Revelation chapter 11.
Gotcha.
And so, what I wanted to say is God, John, I had a fundraiser for some Ethiopian immigrants.
Okay.
And, you know, that has already made Aliyah. As you know, many of the immigrants are making Aliyah.
Okay.
There's over 230,000 have returned.
Wow.
Ethiopians from the Soviet Union, you know, and it's still going on. And they have the top Jewish Christians and Jews in Israel came to us, Wilderness Mountain Ministry, and asked for our help, and they brought one of the Ethiopian immigrants with them in Charleston. And so, and this is where God, you know, opened up the door for us to come to be with you and the Christian people and to share our heart and to reach out to them to bless Israel.
That's good. That's good.
And God also told me there's something out of this. There's a prophecy that is something I'd like to give.
Yeah, go ahead and share it.
Right now, there's a prophecy for the Christians and the people that are, you know, are sick, sicknesses and cancers and, you know, are depressed or, you know, mentally and physically. And this plays a part in God breaking the curses off of us when we bless Israel. There's two chapters that confers to this. Isaiah 58, it says, is this not the time to deal thy bread to the hungry? And I notice this is where God breaks the yoke when we come together. If you remember Apostle Paul, he used other churches. He got other Christians and churches to do other service, to help him do other service. And so I want you to know out there that we can't give up. We're in the greatest time ever of our lives. Such a wonderful time to be living in. And God will. I'm already seeing him heal cancers. He's already healed a man last week of cancer. in Texas. And things are happening, and this is your prophetic word, even for now. And even God says, if you seek me with all your heart, you shall find me. Mm-hmm. And so I just wanted you to know that if you want God to break these curses off, Malachi chapter 3 refers to when he makes up his jewels, referring to Israel, you know, grafting them back in again. He talks about, you know, he would break the curse off of our nation if we would just give and help bless Israel, and that would break the curses, and, you know, he would bless us like never before. This is very urgent for us to reach out to you and plead with you on their behalf.
That's good.
And so I just wanted to let the people know out there that there is healing coming. I call it restoration, the restoration that God foretold of in his word.
We're gonna take a break here just a moment and come back. But what I want to do when we come back from the break, your first point was commerce. And I want to talk a little bit about that whole piece, because commerce is the exchange of goods and services for money. Yes. So when the commerce is affected, and this happened in the time of Daniel, when the commerce and Joseph, when the commerce is affected, God already has something prepared.
Amen.
To really subside what's happening. Even like when our economy failed here, God had already prepared people that were able to withstand this specific time when commerce was affected. So when we come back, I want to talk about your first point, because that lends to why you're doing this, why God has called you to do it at this specific moment, and how much of an effect and impact your obedience is going to have, not just for individuals, but a commerce system. Because you being prepared here today to send the wheat to Israel is going to now make ready for some people to have wheat when the commerce system is not going to be able to give it to them.
Amen.
Are you with me? So we're going to talk a little bit about that when we get back, because this is a good thing. And if you're viewing tonight, listen, this is a prophetically charged environment and atmosphere, and I want you to get in on this, because God's doing some amazing things with this ministry, and he can do some amazing things with you.
Amen.
Israel is always at God's heart.
Yes.
And if we do for Israel, God will do for us.
Amen.
And I want you to remember that. So stay tuned. We're going to find out some more dynamic information. You're going to get some insight, revelatory insight. God's going to talk to you. Well, now we're going to go to music.
Though we may fear the rich man, the man of power. servants who we really want to see, and the one who gives unselfishly is what we want to be. Well, our King is paid to serve us, though some honor it may bring in our hearts. The servant is the King. Servants who we really want to see, and the one who gives unselfishly is what we want to be. Well, our King is paid to serve us, though some honor it may bring in our hearts. The servant is the King. So if you want to be a great man, with all that greatness brings, the burden and the solitude, the fame that never ends. If you want to be remembered, please remember this one thing: the King must be a servant, but the servant is the King.
B.J. Harris, and we're going to hear more from him in the segment later. And he's got a great, strong connection with this group here that is going to blow your mind. God is doing some phenomenal things, and their testimony and their ministry is just a prequel to what God can do in your life if you obey. Let's talk a little bit about, Steve, let's talk about the whole wheat, and we talked about off camera. I wanted to share that with our viewers tonight.
Well, when Jackie and I came together, you were talking about logistics, and timing is everything.
Absolutely.
We look at the weather that we're having now throughout the farmlands, throughout America and Canada, and we see that we're in a very adverse growing conditions. When Jackie and I started this program back in 2008, we had some normalcy to our growing seasons. And so we were able to get several harvests.
Yeah.
And we currently have in storage 180 tons of bread quality spring wheat in Wisconsin, ready to ship to Israel. That'll feed a lot of hungry people.
Oh, yeah.
So timing is everything. God does everything right on time.
Absolutely.
And we had just found out this year through the group that came from Israel to ask us regarding the wheat for the immigrants, that ships are now available, designated just to ship things to Israel.
Wow.
And that one of the logistic problems was getting a shipping line to take our cargo of wheat to Israel. And God is starting to open up that door.
Wow.
So he's opening up many doors.
Yeah.
And he's going to open up the door of finances now so that we can purchase the shipping containers to put the wheat into, to transport it to the port, to get it to Israel, because we know we just have a window of opportunity here before everything shuts down, all the commerce shuts down, just like it did during the time that you were discussing, and also during the time of the Holocaust. Because of war, commerce comes to a screeching halt, and things get very difficult. But God still is able to make a way to preserve His people.
Yeah.
And this is our opportunity to, as Christians, to bless Israel, bless our brothers and sisters there, because He is going, that's the apple of His eye. He's got His eye on Israel. And of course, that's after His own heart.
That's right.
And this is the opportunity for us to receive a blessing. So we as Christians have this magnificent opportunity to help preserve Jacob. Isn't that wonderful?
It's wonderful. Why wheat?
Praise God.
Why wheat and not something else?
Well, the wheat berry, kept in its natural state, will keep indefinitely.
That's it.
And you can transport it.
Non-perishable.
It's non-perishable. God made a perfect envelope. In fact, they've taken wheat berries out of the pyramids and been able to germinate them. So you can see what a perfect package God
has made.
And
what was it that the prophet Joseph, what was it that he preserved as well?
Wheat.
So
yeah.
God is. Do you see the patterns of things? Go ahead. You want to share something else with us?
Yes. It's so very important that we know that war is imminent.
Exactly.
You know, it's coming, and when that happens, it's going to shut down everything.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, you know, and we will not be able to get the wheat there without the help of others. Mm-hmm. You know, the Christians that we're reaching out to. And there's also a cashless system. I don't know if you heard of the Bitcoin.
Okay.
You know, it's a wallet. It's, and you have to have a number or a ID to even operate it or get into it on the computer.
Okay.
And they say that within a year and a half that this will be enforced.
Mm.
And the Bible tells us in Revelation chapter 13, you know, that there is a cashless system coming, not upon just upon the whole world, a global out of Europe.
Gotcha.
You know, and that right there is going. We know that God's people cannot receive a mark.
Gotcha.
So governments can fail.
Mm-hmm.
They do fail.
Yeah.
And when they do, God looks toward us Christians to come right in, you know, and bless Israel.
That's good.
On their behalf.
That's good. That's amazing.
Yes.
Go ahead. What else are we going to share with us?
Well, again, this 3.5-year drought, we know that, you know, Romans chapter 11 says that they're blinded in part.
Okay.
And that it's out of our mercy that they shall obtain mercy, which means that, you know, God is going to take us and, you know, he's going to graft them back in again.
Gotcha.
The scales are going to come off their eyes. They can't see this, mm-hmm. not at this time.
Gotcha.
Until they behold the beast, you know, this rising,
this
Europe, this new cashless system.
Gotcha.
And so it's like a heavy burden upon, you know, just two or three with a handful of people.
Gotcha.
And God says, go now and tell, go to the churches and even ask them if, you know, if it would be all right if you would like to have us to come to your church and speak or and sing, you know, maybe for some love offerings that go toward that project of feeding Israel, that we will be glad to do so.
Mm-hmm.
You can go to wildernessmountainministry.org and read all about our vision for Israel.
You know, what's interesting is, as we're talking, I'm thinking about the story of Nehemiah. And Nehemiah had favor with the king that he was a cupbearer for.
Yeah.
And prior to going on his journey to go back and rebuild the walls, the king did him a great favor.
Yes, he did.
He gave him favor with the outpost who had the resources to help him do what he was called to do. So there's an appeal tonight. For people who are on the outpost that you could come into contact with on your journey trying to get this thing together, because it is time sensitive. And I want to keep saying that so that somebody viewing tonight may connect with this prophetic thing that God is doing with you and understand the time sensitive magnitude of it and say, hey, I want to give towards that thing. So how do they reach you? What is your website address? How do they get more information about how they can connect with you?
Okay, then just go to wildernessmountainministry.org. On our homepage, and you'll read a lot about the vision. You'll find our telephone numbers there. You can contact me at Brother Jackie at wildernessmountainministry.org, my email address. And also, there's even a donate button there for PayPal if you God leads you to give an offering, a love offering to Israel. And there's many other things there that I deal with in the prophetic realm. That you may be interested in. And, you know, as Kim and I, we used to have a healing ministry also years ago, but I don't want to go into that. I'm just, because this is very urgent to saving lives.
Gotcha.
And so just go to our website and check us out and read all about it. You'll be able to see some of the Israela Asego, one of the Ethiopian immigrants who came to America to sing and testify of how she made it back home and her family. And so it will really bless your heart to read it and check it out. And we do have DVDs on there if you can choose from the list of different messages. And we don't sell. There's one thing about this ministry. We don't sell anything. We just, you know, we just give it as a love offering, and we just trust God to speak to the people and put it on their heart what to do.
Gotcha. Let's recap a little bit just to bring our viewers a full circle. You guys, God is doing something in you. He's telling you to do something that is kind of a Noah type thing. It's strange. It's yes. It's something that's abnormal. You're thinking, oh, why this? Mm-hmm. God's saying the same thing to you. And there's a meeting that happens. I don't know where this meeting is. South Carolina?
South Carolina.
South Carolina. You guys converge at this meeting.
Yes.
Not knowing that this would be the connection point for the vision God has given both of you that link you together.
Right.
So you're coming to this meeting not knowing
exactly.
that the real purpose for this
exactly.
meeting is not the meeting,
right.
but a prophetic meeting.
Amen.
So you meet at the meeting. You're like-minded. God has given you, both of you, vision that connects, that brings
yes.
synergy, and the timing is right.
Exactly.
And then you guys embark on this Noah-type endeavor to do something that seems strange. The resource that you're storing up for Israel is also a resource that they export to other countries.
Yes.
So they're a resource that they have already on hand is not going to be accessible. So God says, before the time that it's not accessible, I want you to prepare the ram in the bush, if you will,
yes.
so that when their commerce is affected, mm-hmm. you are already present with the remedy.
That's right.
That's right.
Is that ultimately
yes,
what we're saying?
Ultimately,
right
on. You hit it.
Now,
right
this is amazing. Now, I want to say that because God can talk to people to do things that seem strange.
Yes.
Noah, I'm sure he had to scratch his head. What do you mean, build an ark? God, really?
What is that? Yeah,
yes. And so I'm saying that to say that I want you to encourage the people out there tonight that God can tell you to do something real strange.
Yes.
He can.
And if you obey,
Amen.
You'll see the fullness of it. Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, the obedience. You can use Abraham.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he just got up and walked off.
Yeah.
Going to a country, you know. His builder and maker is God, and he was tried for like 25 years. And by the way, guess how long me and my wife's been
25
together?
25 years.
25
Look at God.
Years. Right on the nail.
25 years. Amazing.
And it's amazing that, you know, he just told us, I'm from Georgia. My wife's from Georgia.
Rome.
Rome, Georgia. Marietta. And you know, he brought us together. We were really tried, mm-hmm. you know, like Abraham and Sarah.
Gotcha.
And so it was really difficult times or trials, but good experience
gotcha.
Says it all.
Gotcha.
And so, you know, he told us to just get up and leave our families, just like Abraham,
mm-hmm.
and go to the promised land, go like Joshua and Caleb,
mm-hmm.
and spy out the land or,
yeah.
you know, find a place mm-hmm. to store this wheat, and I will go before you.
Yeah.
I will go to the churches. I will go before you everywhere, you know, and prepare.
That's good.
That way before you.
That's good. Amazing. Did you want to share anything with us tonight? We have
yes.
about 2 minutes remaining
yes,
in the statement.
Yes, I do. Our ministry really is about Revelations 12, 6, and 14.
Awesome.
And the woman fled into the wilderness where she has a place prepared of God.
That's good.
And that's where we come in. We're
that's
preparing
good.
This place for God's people in Israel.
That's good.
I got one more thing.
Go ahead.
You know, there's something that I discovered after this fundraiser by accepting the immigrant's request for help.
Mm-hmm.
It was about a week later, I was sitting in a chair, and God says, go to Isaiah, I believe it was in Isaiah. No, it talks about 10 men that's in other languages
Zechariah.
Of nations. Zechariah
8,
I believe it is.
23.
Or 23, something like that. Just read the book of Zechariah. 8, and you'll find is there's 10 men out of all the languages that sees a Jew. He looks at his coattail and he says, we have heard that God is with you.
Wow.
Let us go with you.
Wow. Wow.
Referring to, you know, the elder brother, Judah, and the younger brother, the grafted in Gentiles.
That's good. We're going to have an opportunity at the end after BJ gives us another selection. We're going to have a moment at the end to wrap this thing up. We're going to have about 4 minutes. And so I want you to get prepared for your closing remarks after BJ gives us some worship. But I'm telling you, I'm excited about what God is doing and the fact that you obeyed. I can't get past the whole aspect that God chose you to do something that only you could do. And because he knew you'd obey, you wouldn't ask any questions, and he knew you had the type of character to be able to meet people on the outpost that would connect and partner with you to make sure that this was financially possible and that it could take place. So that says a lot about how God believes in you and the faith he has in you to do something of this magnitude. We serve a big God.
Sure do.
Whenever he tells us to do something, it's going to be bigger than our minds can comprehend.
That's right.
He says, now unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think, according to the power that works in us.
Praise
amazing. Let's go to music, guys.
Sides eroded, fields barren of men, till I heard heaven call, prepare, they come again. I am Israel, I am God's holy land, I am Israel, I belong to no man. I am Israel, and my people have come, I am Israel, I and my people are one. To them all I open my heart. They have come home at last and will never, never depart. Though many great nations have trampled my soil, many wars have been fought, many kingdoms been spoiled. Not one noticed my mountains, my streams long to see. Only one tiny people has sung their songs to me. I am Israel, I am God's holy land, I am Israel, I belong to no man. I am Israel, and my people have come, I am Israel, I and my people are one. To them only I open my heart, they have come home at last and will never, never depart. Neglected, despised, derided, profaned, we have suffered in silence because of the name. The 2,000-year war shall soon come to an end. Every nation shall bow their knee and bless Jerusalem. I am Israel, I am God's holy land, I am Israel, I belong to no man. I am Israel, and my people have come, I am Israel, I and my people are one. To them only I open my heart, they have come home at last and will never, never depart. I am Israel, I belong to no man, I am Israel, and my people have come, I am Israel, I and my people are one. To them only I open my heart, they have come home at last and will never, never depart. To them only I open my heart, they have come home at last and will never, never depart, never depart, never depart.
Sound of the shofar. Listen, BJ has been with us tonight, and I just want you to meet him and hear his testimony, hear what God is doing in his life. He's provided some phenomenal worship. Now it's time for you to meet him. BJ, thank you so much for being with us. I'll grab that for you.
Thank you, John, for being with us tonight, man. Thanks so much for having us here.
Tell us a bit about you and what God's doing in your life.
Well, I'm Jewish. I grew up Jewish. I'm still Jewish.
Gotcha.
But I'm a Jewish person who has met his Messiah. Mm-hmm. And that was a long process, probably my whole life. But I think God's been following me around, waiting for that moment when I could, when the veil would be parted. You know, Paul says there's a veil over the eyes of the Jewish people. And because of the prayers of Christians like you and many that I meet who met me and diligently prayed for me, tried to witness to me, that was very difficult because I would usually spit in their faces. But they were patient and kind, and they showed me the love of my Messiah. And they, you know, many of them would speak to me about Messiah rather than saying Jesus Christ. They'd say, Yeshua, the Messiah of Israel. He's your Messiah. And they came a point where all that prayer came together, and I began to see the truth that I had been veiled from me for from all of us for thousands of years.
How did you meet the wonderful guys from Wilderness Mountain Ministries? Tell us how that took place.
Well, that's kind of funny because we met at the synagogue, a traditional Jewish synagogue. We'd gone there separately to see some videos about Israel and about how to support Israel. Mm-hmm. And afterwards, we just started talking. They asked an intelligent question. I asked an intelligent question. We said, well, to people who kind of know what's going on.
Gotcha.
And so, because the Jewish people, they're very intelligent people, but they don't understand the prophetic significance of what's happening.
That's good.
And so, you know, we began to talk afterwards, and we realized that we had a lot in common, and I wanted to help them. When I found out they were raising wheat for Israel, I immediately, you know, wanted to help and support their ministry.
Awesome. We got about 2 minutes left in the segment, and then we're going to give you some more time to do worship. Tell us about this CD that I have in my hand.
Yes, this CD it's called Come to Jerusalem. That was a song that God gave me when I finally got born again. Mm-hmm. And because when I had been a very young man, a supernatural power had flowed through my apartment like a river at a very low point in my life, and I didn't understand what it was. But when I was told that I could ask Yeshua, my Messiah, into my heart, I kept doing that, and nothing was happening. And I went to this church, and a man prayed with me, and as he prayed with me, I saw a vision of this giant stone wall like the walls of Jericho.
Okay.
And as he prayed, that wall came tumbling down, and the Spirit of God came pouring out of the ceiling all over me, and God told me that when I had come to Jerusalem, I had felt His peace, felt His power, that in my apartment that day He had come to give me peace, and though I didn't know what it was, but now that He had come into me, that Jerusalem had come into me, and I would carry Jerusalem every place I went.
Wow. Amazing. Had your own Christophany, your own encounter with God.
Right.
Amazing.
And then he gave me this song, Come to Jerusalem, and he wrote it as fast as I could write.
Gotcha.
The song came out, words and melody, and there it was.
How did he reach you? Your website, email address?
My website is cometojerusalem.org. My email address is cometojerusalem@gmail.com, and they can call me, request an album or information, and I've got a few teachings up on my website, not a whole lot, but...
Okay. All right, well, we got 30 seconds. What do you want to close with?
Well, just, I just want to talk to the people out there is if you have Yeshua, the Messiah of Israel, in your heart, then Jerusalem has come home to you, and you have the power, the authority, the anointing to carry Jerusalem everywhere you go, carry God's peace, God's love, and that's what the Jewish people particularly need, but everyone needs to know the love of our Messiah. He loved me when I was not worth being loved, and we have the power and the ability to love others no matter what they treat us like.
BJ, I'm going to get out your way so we can get this great song. Bless you, man.
God bless. Thank you. Sacrifice. I'll trade my life for you to prove my love is true. Children of Abraham, come to Jerusalem. Come to Jerusalem. Come to the Prince of Peace. Come to the great I Am. Let your searching cease, and when your heart has made room for my throne within, then everywhere you go, you'll bring Jerusalem. On a mountain in a wilderness, I made my home, a temple on the earth where I placed heaven's throne. And every year you brought a lamb to sacrifice, the Passover that covered your sin from my eyes. Children of Abraham, come to Jerusalem. To a mountain in a wilderness the prophet came, the mighty God, the Prince of Peace, they called his name. On a mountain in a wilderness he died alone. Soon it was destroyed, that temple made of stone. The final sacrifice, Messiah gave his life. Children of Abraham, come to Jerusalem. Come to Jerusalem. Come to the Prince of to the great I Am, and let your searching cease. And when your heart has made room for my throne within, then everywhere you go, you'll bring Jerusalem. Sing with me, come to Jerusalem. Come to Jerusalem, Prince of Peace. Come to the Prince of Peace, the great I Am. Come to the great I Am. Let your searching cease, and let your searching cease. And when your heart is made, and when your heart has made room for my throne within, room for my throne within, then everywhere you go, then everywhere you go, you'll bring Jerusalem. You'll bring Jerusalem. Come to the bread of life, the wine of sacrifice. Children of Abraham, come to Jerusalem.
Amazing. BJ, that was amazing. We were here like a quartet singing background for him. So we were in the spirit with him. Amazing, amazing ministry of BJ. Please visit his website and invite him out to your ministry. He'll bless your ministry. He's carrying Jerusalem in his heart. The peace of God, the shalom of God is with him, and you'll be blessed by it. Listen, I want to, our last 4 minutes on air tonight, you had a word you want to release. I want you to release that word tonight.
I do have a word for somebody out there.
Okay.
People, especially in these kinds of times, are wanting to do something for God, but don't know where to go.
Yeah.
because of all of the confusion that is out there today. I want the people to know that Jackie and I, or none of our members of this ministry, draw a salary. We have taken the entire fortunes that God has placed in our hands in our lifetime and put it into this ministry. So we are first partakers. And there is somebody out there that I know that God is speaking to their heart tonight, that He has blessed financially, and they want to do something big for God. Like you were saying, John, before about this ministry, this is a big deal. God is doing something big for Israel, for His people, the apple of His eye. He's got His eye on Israel. And of course, people are saying, well, how can I help? What can I do for God that's special? And what we're endeavoring to do is to purchase that place in Israel and to get this foodstuffs to Israel. That takes money. And of course, we're going to need help. And I know that God prophesied that He would speak to somebody's heart out there to partner with us and come in and be a part of something that God is doing, something that's magnificent.
Yeah.
They might even want to go to Israel and be part of this. Yeah. And this is an opportunity for someone out there in your listening audience that God is speaking to their heart as I speak right now. I know that's true. I can just feel it inside. It's bubbling up within me. You know what I mean?
Amen.
So someone out there, God is speaking to your heart to do something special for Him, just like we dropped whatever we were doing 10 years ago to do something special for God. We had no idea we would get to this point and make a difference to save lives. And by the way, one thing I wanted to add, John, this is the first time in my relationships with Jews that God has actually broke down the barriers between Jews and Christians, where they are setting aside their differences to work together for a common good. And that is to preserve His people in this time of trouble that is about to befall upon the face of this earth.
30 seconds.
The urgency of the hour, we only have about a year to get this wheat to Israel, and we need your help. And if you want to be blessed, you can bless Israel by blessing this ministry.
Amen.
Okay, and I just wanted to tell you that, can you imagine when their eyes are open and they realize that us Christians have joined together to feed them and to preserve the next generation? What a blessed time that's going to be, as what I believe is God reconciling the dry bones and bringing all the dry bones together, just like in Joseph, who sustained his brothers. So I just wanted to leave you with that God will, says, I will bless those that bless Israel.
Amen.
And so God bless you.
Thank you guys for being on tonight.
Thank you.
It's been an honor to have you on with us tonight.
Thank you, John,
bless you,
for having us.
Listen, guys, as the broadcast draws to an end, I want to leave you with this. One instruction from God could be a history-making provisional moment for people that you haven't even met. When God gives you instruction to do something, i.e. Noah, i.e. the ministry that they have, when God gives you something to do, you have to know without a shadow of a doubt that the ramifications of what you're about to do is going to impact more than just you and your generation. It is imperative, and I say this prophetically, it is imperative that you obey and do exactly what God is telling you to do. Somebody is going to be on the receiving end tomorrow of your obedience today. I'm John Pace from New Life Christian Ministries in Niceville, Florida, the place where life comes together and your fresh start begins. On behalf of Atlanta Live, WATC TV, and the entire Atlanta Live crew, God bless you. And have a great night.